So today is going to be a semi-fun, semi-interesting day. We are going to go ride my oversized iguana slash dog because gas prices are way too expensive, to Sonic to go get food because I'm hungry. And then we're probably gonna go to Joann's and start our Elsa costume. So let's go. Liberty is ready to go.
We're going to Sonic, to Sonic, to Sonic. We're going to Sonic. Whatever will we get? Dang, gas prices really do be high these days. Just riding my rocket donkey downtown, moving fast. Something da-da-da-da-da. But we were Sonic bound. We're off to Sonic. Oh my god.
The amount of weird stares I'm getting for riding my horse into town. I mean, this isn't that. Really? Isn't that unique? Okay. We're not jumping the white lines. The white lines are just on the ground, dude. Like, seriously. Gas is expensive. People are driving cars that around here is like $3 a gallon. Can't afford that. So therefore, I'm gonna be taking my red dog here that goes one alfalfa flake for 50 miles. Liberty and I made it to Sonic. I got a mango slushie. Oops, she got a water. Did you want fries with that?
You good?
Nope.
Yep. You good on the water? You need any more? Any more? No.
So the Sonic drinks do not reach Liberty standards, but apparently the grass does. So that's where we're at right now. She's more interested in the cows behind us right now than really anything.
What? Thank you.
We are now at the post office and I'm gonna go get my mail and you're not gonna move. You're gonna just stay right here, okay? I'll take that as a yes. Just do me a favor, don't move. Excuse me.
What's your horse's name?
My horse's name, Liberty.
Liberty?
Yes, sir, Liberty.
Good looking horse.
Thank you, she's also a very good horse.
Hello, Liberty. How you doing?
We just took a trip to Sonic, now we're at the post office, now we're going home. Right, buddy? She is. Who's a good male pony? Yes. Yes, it's a good girl. Like, that's us. You see your shadow? Say hi to the shadow. Good girl. Liberty is back at the barn, all clean, and now we are getting ready for dinner, and we're gonna go to Joann's. So now Mom and I are heading off to Joann's, and it is already freaking dark outside because it's winter and it gets dark at like 4:30 these days. But anyway, to Joann's.
One that's new.
What do you think of that one?
I think you should line it with one of these. Be closer to a similar fabric. I know which one I like better, but
am I picking between this one and this one?
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna go with this one.
Oh, see, I liked the feel of this one better.
Oh, but you're going on feel, not color.
Yeah. Let me see which ones you picked.
Which one?
This one, oh, my hair is staticky. This one seems to be more of like a shiny. Do you think this was too turquoisey for Elsa?
That's completely the wrong Elsa. That's Spirit Elsa.
Whatever.
We're looking for, is there a Frozen 1 Elsa doll? No. All right, they close in 10 minutes.
Did you video?
Okay, it's like the next day because yesterday I was working for my employer making shirts for her store, but we're back, we're here, we're working. So we've got this, got my pattern, got a zipper and measuring tape, and this I wasn't actually supposed to get, but I did because it was on sale for $3 a yard, and I have no self-control. It's Anna. Not the point. That's not what you came here for. You came here for Elsa. We're getting to Elsa. This is our fabric. Let's get on with this. Time to open this entire thing and find what we're looking for. Time lapse.
Welcome to the part of the show where I have no idea what to talk about. So instead of talking about what's going on in the video, I talk about utter randomness or literally just whatever comes to my mind.
All right, so right now we're gonna get started on the bodice lining. So these are our pieces. Follow the pattern, cut them out to your size. Okay, here we go.
Do you ever get that feeling after you finish sewing something and you literally just want to do it over again one more time because you already can figure out what you can do to change it to make it better? Yeah, this corset is one of those things.
Can we just talk about how much we all hate Prince Hans, if we can even call him that? And I personally think his horse is just too good for his rotten ass. Like, that horse is utterly beautiful and is way too good of a pure soul for him, and he's stuck with a rider like Hans.
We all love a good Disney villain, Scar, Cruella, but Hans, we just hate his guts.
Okay, we're back. So you're supposed to have a shape like this for your bodice, the front of the bodice. Not this. Make note of that. Always check your folds. On the pattern. The pattern. I love crazy.
All my life has been a series of doors in my face.
Then suddenly I bump into you.
I'm thinking the same thing. Just like I've been searching my whole life to find my own place. And maybe it's a party talking or the chocolate fondue.
But with you, I see your face. And it's nothing.
I vividly remember this movie coming out in 2013 and watching the scene of Let It Go and thinking, wow, this is the peak of cinematic perfection.
Well, now let it go, let it go. Can't hold it back anymore. Let the storm rage on. The cold never bothered me anyway.
We are at the point where Prince Hans is passing out cloaks and the Duke of Weaselton is losing his mind about the wicked. You could probably hear it. But anyway, he's literally just passing out stuff the kingdom already had. Why is everyone praising him? He's not even that good looking. I mean, he's a redhead, so the devil lives in his soul.
So if and when I redo this costume, I can already tell you the things that I'm going to change. This cape being one of them. Now, I actually liked the way it turned out in the end, but as I was sewing it and piecing it together, it just was not my cup of tea. I would also probably make more layers for the corset with this sparkly material, or just make the corset a separate piece in itself instead of just making it one big dress. Now, let's get back to the movie. Can we just talk about how amazing Kristoff is as a Disney prince, or Ice Master, as Anna calls him? I mean, he is just the utter sweetest guy in the world. And Sven, I mean, we all love Sven. Copyrighted music.
Okay, so we have now cut out our bodice and the cape and a few other random things, and now we're going to cut out our the outside of our skirt. So
one thing I hate working with sewing is silk. If I can avoid it, I avoid it like the plague. I knew I wouldn't be able to do that with Elsa, but for the rest of my costumes, fair warning, there will be no silk involved.
Now we're doing the purple lining as we watch Shrek and Fairy Godmother sing I Need a Hero, Where Have All the Good Men Gone? It's Raining Men. I'm not really sure what the song is.
About halfway through this whole project, I stopped watching the Frozen movies and even all of the Olaf shorts and just switched gears completely to watching Shrek and Law and Order and Criminal Minds and SVU and NCIS, and it took a little bit of a dark turn, but quite frankly, those movies and TV shows are my absolute jam when sewing. Now I try to get into the spirit of the costume and watch the movie or TV series that it came from, but honestly, I can't help but watch Psych or Numbers or Criminal Minds or anything that involves homicide and murder and criminals and police and everything along those lines. It's a weird thing my mom and I like to do, watching these sort of shows. But you know what? I just find them fascinating and interesting, and I learn a lot about our law system and, well, criminals.
We got our cup of, chat.
Maybe you've let humans into your hotel room, but I don't think you've let them into your heart.
So now we're sewing together our lining part of the skirt. Just follow the instructions. We're sewing together the lining of the skirt. We've already got the skirt, and then we're going to sew them together and then attempt to tear up it and then make a slit. Okay, let's go.
A really bad habit that I have when sewing is thinking about what costume I'm going to make next when I haven't even got the one I'm working on done.
So now what we're gonna do, and this is the part where we stop following the pattern completely and we do our own thing. So we turned the main skirt inside out and we take our lining, find where the zipper is gonna go right there, and put it inside. And then find the zipper top here. Where did it go? Is it the other side? It is the other side. Okay. Tuck it in. Yep. This side. This side. Here we go. Put it in. And then find your two seams. Match them up. Remember, right sides facing each other. So when you turn it inside out, it'll be correct. I don't follow pins a lot, but when you're coming to precision and you're working with silks, I would really recommend you pinning it. Unless you absolutely are positive that you can do it right the first time. But even then, the best thing to do is use pens. Just use pens. Don't be like me and be stubborn and lazy because you are trying to save time.
Just pin the things.
Pin them down.
Okay, for my next costume, I can't really decide between Ariel from The Little Mermaid or Erica from the Barbies, The Princess, and the Pauper. Now, I'm leaning more towards Erica because I have brown hair and I don't presently have an Ariel wig.
So I sort of find it a little bit suspicious with how much sparkle fabric I have left because I got the exact amount that the pattern recommended and I have a lot extra, but I've cut all the pieces out that require sparkle,
so I'm not really sure what's happening, and I'm scared to cut out extra pieces of this because I might be using this for something else, and I'm not entirely sure what it's for. So we're gonna just cut more of these out. And if I need sparkle fabric later because I didn't follow instructions, because I don't like to, oh well. At this point, I'm not really sure if during my voiceovers I will ever actually explain what I'm doing in any of these videos. I mean, quite frankly, you should just watch what I do. That might just be because I'm a visual learner and I don't really learn well when people are just explaining things to me. I need to watch it and I need to just do it for myself and experiment and fail at it multiple times before I finally get it right or I'm satisfied with the outcome of this. Now, with this bodice in particular and the lining inside of it, I probably took it apart from the skirt and from itself 3 or 4 times and sewed it back together because I just was not satisfied with the way it was laying on my body.
Okay, so now what we're gonna do is take the wrong sides and sew the top part one that'll go right here together. So you can just dump it on the street.
The amount of holes I now have in my fingers is astronomical, and this lace and silk was absolutely horrendous to work with, and my fingers just became pincushions.
So you're going to want to sew along everything, actually. Everything just gets sewn together. So make it one piece of fabric. Sew along everything. Remember, good sides facing out. You're going to want the good sides out because you're going to be sewing this part to this thing, this part to the bottom of the skirt, and then this part to the zipper. So
I haven't really decided what part of sewing I like more. Picking out the fabric, cutting it out, sewing it together, piecing it, designing it at the end, doing embellishments, or looking at the finished product. Now, I sort of get an itch when I'm not sewing, but I get the satisfaction from finishing it. But I also don't like leaving projects not finished.
Now, the pattern doesn't call for this, but where did my piece go? Ah. Not the curling iron. So the pattern doesn't call for this, but this goes right here. But how are you expected to finish off the collar? You can fold it under and sew the top. I've never liked doing that. So what we're going to do is we cut out the same pieces again to make another one of these. And we're going to sew it along the neck, turn it inside out. And then this part will be connected to the sleeves. And then this part will be connected to the bodice. So let's do this.
Okay, you'll see this later in the video, but I end up dyeing the entire dress, at least I tried to dye it turquoise, but the amount of sparkles that came off in the water looked like a potion out of something from Harry Potter. Like, honestly, it was so beautiful.
Alright, so this is what we have so far. It's definitely a smock, and I went with the smallest size possible, and it's still pretty big, and my mom said that I might need to go up to a medium. No, I trusted my gut and went with the smallest size, and still it's too big, and it is way too long. So what we're gonna have to do is hem it, take it in, and probably take the corset off the skirt again, sew it back together, and make it a couple sizes smaller. So let's do this.
I'm probably going to do this before I wear this to an event or something, but I'll probably be taking like adhesive spray-on glue, spraying the entire cape, and then just like sneezing glitter onto it to maybe give it more sparkle, because again, so much sparkle came off in that water, but it still looks pretty. I managed to salvage a little bit of the glitter and it's now in a bowl drying, but glitter glue might be an option.
Now we are getting the dye ready to dye the bottom half ombre of our dress over there. Sherman, come taste this. Come here. You wanna try it?
It's probably hot.
Yummy. Yeah.
Longstreet's like, I'm out of here.
I'm not really sure what the dogs thought I was doing in the kitchen, but they thought it was food. It was not food. It was an Elsa dress.
You put it over there on that side or something. I could put it on that side, but I like this angle before doing it. Okay, you added that. Now to add the vinegar. wrong street. You're right in the way, man.
All
right,
okay. Can you still have one, too?
We're making soup tonight. R.I.P. this dress. It's literally just glitter. It's just glitter soup. You can literally see the steam.
Hold on, so you can see it.
It's so freaking hot. Where's the top? Okay, here.
This water burned my hands so freaking bad. And the end result was a little bit better than the original Cinderella color, but it did not do what it was supposed to do.
Okay, so because my hands are literally turning blue and burn, we're gonna put a trash bag on my feet and then use my feet to keep the fabric down in the dye.
Now, when I started using my feet to dye the thing, my dad thought I was crazy, but I thought it was ingenious.
Your feet?
Damn!
This is burning my foot.
Yeah. I'm not sure your foot's helping any.
Yes, it is. I'm kicking it down. Is it just me, or does this look blue, not turquoise?
It definitely looks blue. That's why you never... Oh, it's snagging. Oh, Samantha, that snagged it.
No!
It did. It snagged it. All right, so...
Bad spoon! Throw that spoon out!
There must be something on there.
We have our Elsa costume on. It's 23 degrees outside, and it was snowing last night in other parts of Texas, but was not snowing here. So, we're gonna just set this up over here and get some footage of this. Here we go. No, just make sure they don't hit me. I need shoes. Elsa's not barefoot until the second movie. I need shoes. Feel my little flip.
I'm gonna stick with the music here.
Okay, I'm cold, going outside. I'm done.